Okay, here we go. This is my 65cc beginner class at Prophetstown. And this is Luke Ward. Okay. Might be a little bit. Might be a small bit. Whoops. I was still in neutral. I forgot to shift into first. Okay, so I'm in last place here. And I catch up to this mohawk guy. I didn't know why he had a mohawk on. I guess that's just helmet. Then I always overshoot one of the corners that we don't take on the first lap. And I really, not really, but a little one mohawk. So I'm stuck behind this guy a little bit. Okay, run this corner. Here I got a little bit of air later on in the race. Then I came around this corner on the outside. Thought I could pass in the air. Nope, no chance. Oh, and then this is where I passed him. I'm pretty sure at this time there's some person behind me. And then I just blast past. Yep, there was someone right there. I just blasts past me. Now go this way. There's bumps on the inside. That's what I didn't think. That was good at the beginning in practice, but when everybody had done practice, that was all chewed out. So it was still a good line, but just made it a little harder. Around this nice open corner. Okay. Going down straight away. I got into, I think the most third. I think third was my highest gear. I'm pretty sure I was shifting to the whole horse. Coming along here. Big nice open hand room. This was all the slower part. I'm pretty sure when I went on the outside it felt faster. I don't know if it was faster. Overshoot this next corner. See? I barely overshoot it. You'll notice that I overshoot it in almost all the rest of the lines. Go on the inside there. The course, I would put on a scale of 1 to 10, possibly 9. The course was pretty easy, but there was a couple hard parts. The reason why I rated it 9 is because it's harder to pass on this course. Because you've got to wait till the exact right time. So this is my second lap. And racing a 65, a KTM. I never can remember the year. I can't ever remember a year. A hard parts in this course, like line choices. See, when I don't need that inside line, usually I don't take it. Because then if anybody steps faster than me, wants to pass me, they can pass me through there. On my practice, my first practice lap, I didn't get the course, because it didn't seem to me like it was marked very well, so I got confused. And then when I got it, I was getting pretty good at it. When you see the green flags when I go through this part, that was where we started. And my dad was back there. You'll see him throughout the race. With a good reason, because he's my dad. A couple corners got pretty hard. Like this one was a little soft. I think I should have been in second gear for that corner instead of third. I think that would have been a good idea. And then here we go around this. Take the inside line. Quick around this corner. Man, this course was harder than I thought it would be. Like this a couple of the corners were a little soft, and there wasn't very many passing places. In fact, I think there's only like one or two. Then when I see my dad appear, yep, that was him. The one that I think, it looks like he had a white hat on. That's the place where he passed that Mohawk kid. And then, I think I remember this part good. Oh yeah, I remember this part. Go around this corner. When I went through here, my mind was thinking, on this next corner, I'm gonna pass it good. See, quick line choice here. Right through there. A little bumpy, but fast. I'm gonna get back to my fast speed. I got a little faster throughout the race because I got more confident in myself. It's a lot better when you just have a lot of trust in you, and I just don't know. This is my first time, but this is my first beginner's race. And the second race of the year. So I did a really hard sand course farther up on the year. That was earlier in the year, I mean. See, there's the green flags. And comment if you like. This isn't, well. If you like the commentary, please just comment and like, please. And then, around that one soft corner, little rare time, whee! And then, go around here. See, that time I didn't overshoot it. And that time, I didn't overshoot, which is good. And I like not overshooting things. Then around here, pretty, a little bumpy. And then around here, nice couple solid corners. I like the variety of corners. Like there's, you've got these non, like these tight corners, and then these more wide corners, and then you got soft corners, and then you got hard backed corners. And then you got two lines on that one corner where I passed that other kid. And I took the inside. So, oh, and I almost forgot. Be sure to subscribe. Then this long, fast straightaway. That was my dad again, in the white hat. Not the one in the blue clothes. Around this corner. This whole track was kind of sandy, but there were a couple hard-packed corners. So, there were no big sticks or logs that I had to go over. And that's good. I raced the beginners because I didn't know if I was able to handle the normal 65 class. So I raced the beginners. And I think I could have done the normal track. The normal 65 track. And then we're almost halfway into the race, I'm pretty sure. And that, so, and here I felt good. There's the green flags where we started again. Around this corner. And I'm pretty sure on this lap I started to take the inside. Yeah, I started to take the inside. That really felt like it slowed me down a lot more. Another sandy corner. And I just saw the Mohawk kid. Yeah, he's right up there. Oh, little dirt or mud on there. Yep, there's the Mohawk kid. I like his Mohawk. Nice yellow color. So when you come around to lap people on this course, I think it was a lot harder. I thought I could pass in there. Nope, didn't work. Gonna come around here. Hurry up, kid. Hurry up, faster. Faster, soldier! Faster! Wow. Can this kid even hear? I don't know. Probably not. Around this corner, and you have another nice corner. Here's another spot I thought I could pass in, but would have just been a little more aggressive on the throttle, maybe I could have. Then here's another part where I passed him. It took me a little longer there because I took the I took the inside there. It took me a little longer to pass him that time because I didn't take the outside. I took the inside and basically just followed him. Here's that one spot where they don't go through there. My favorite part about the course was when You'll see on, like, I think the next lap, my favorite part of the course. I'll tell you about it when we get there. Okay. Faster, faster, faster. Slower. Faster! Yay! Around here, found a couple faster lines that got a little fat, that were a little faster than others. For instance, on this, I don't know if I took like just the middle. That was my dad we just passed. Okay, we're almost done with another lap. Then there was a girls class that was right behind us. And then this is one of the girls. Then there was, I'm pretty sure, another kid behind me here. And he got past me easily. I heard him, but I didn't see him until he passed me. So I got stuck behind. Oh yeah, I'm pretty sure like right here. Well, maybe next couple corners. It was like right. I had to shift down to second here because, yeah. And then here, yeah, I stalled it. What was that for, dude? Well, I guess he just was. I guess he didn't mean to do it. He shoved me off the track. Cause, surprise, some other people are coming. He didn't want me to get run into. Looking, there's that Mohawk kid. I had to pass him again. A couple more kids. Oh, yeah. There's that kid. He went through that bumpy spot. Okay, now we're back going again. That's good. A lot better now. Back brapping in the woods. When I say brap, that I mean riding a dirt bike. That's what I mean by brap. So, round this corner. Nice tight corners. A couple nice tight corners. And then, well, I've completed a lap so far over that little air time jump. Around this corner. Then here's where I catch up to them big time. Then here, I just let loose. Power meter pipe. Follow this first, this kid this way. I'm pretty sure. I can't tell if that was the kid that made me stall the bike. No, it probably wasn't. And then, my favorite part of the course is coming up. Yeah, right? Yeah, this is my favorite part of the course, the inside line there. I took the outside. There's that one kid. He was faster there. Around a couple more corners. Nice couple sweep, wider corners. And then, got a couple of tight corners, a couple of wide corners. And then you got your sandy corners, your hard packed corners. Then, it was kind of hard to learn how the track went. But once I got it down, I got pretty good at it. And then, around this other one, there's the green flags again. Okay. And then, we got stuck behind that one girl again. With three people, like, I'm pretty sure like three people are stuck behind her. But there's that one kid that was super fast. And he took the outside there, got a nice on her. I thought I could speed up here and pass her. No chance. I think I overshot that. Nope. Clean pass there. That's better. Right past her. She got right out of the way on that one corner. A couple bumps in that one corner. And then around this corner. A couple of them on the very inside there. And then up here. Well, not really up there. Around here. There we go, that's better. Tight corner. We just passed my dad again. He was on the right side. And then here, we got good corners. Got, okay, come right around here. Whee! Super fast. Oh, super fast though. Around this corner. Then, there's that one bumpy line. Then I hop right through there. Through there. And then I think I still run into the slower kids. It's just because, well, there are different classes. There's, I think the girl 65, and then I think a couple boys also went with the girls. So there's a boys 50, girls 50, beginner. This was a beginner's race, so I was racing with girls 50 beginners and boys 50 beginners. So we've got boys and girls on the track. Okay, so I'm behind this kid for a little bit. That was that kid, one kid that I passed on the inside earlier in the race. Whoa, right past him. That was fun. I think my second favorite part, about the race was passing people. Because when you pass people, it just feels really good because you don't have to, because then you can get back to your normal speed. Because if they're slower than you, once you get back to your normal speed, you get better. Then I think we're almost done with the race. Here. Still a speck of mud on the GoPro. And then around here. Wasn't a lot of places to. There wasn't a lot of branches reaching out to like hit your goggles or to hit your helmet or bike. So that was a. That was good. And there's my dad. Okay. Whee! Airtime. When I raced it, I thought I got first or second. Nope. At the end of the race, you'll really see what place I got. rate myself at a scale of 1 to 10, I think I would rate myself 8 or 7, because I could have taken a couple other lines. Like, I could have taken that faster line and pre-lap, and that would have made me have to pass a little more people, I'm pretty sure. And then, yeah, I think this is my last lap. Yeah, this is my last lap. So, it's a pretty good race. Right through here. And then, right here. Yes, we have like 3 minutes. Well, not. We only have a couple minutes left in the race, I'm pretty sure. So, there's the flag, so we're just about done with our lap. You can see people are gathering over there to congratulate the kids. You can see right there. And then, once I get around the last corner, it feels so good. But until then, gotta go around here. Inside, a little slower. And then past that kid. And then around this corner. Final corner! Yay! A couple kids stopped like right on the racetrack, so I couldn't. I came there with a little bit of speed, so I went right over to my dad.